Teschler with Design World and EE World, and I'm here with Kyle Kim from Eaton, and we're talking about supercapacitors. Kyle, first of all, what's the difference between a supercapacitor and a regular capacitor with just a couple of plates and an insulator between them?
So the supercapacitor has about 1,000 times more energy densities than the regular capacitors. The way we achieve it is by having a special material that has a high surface area, and then reduce the distance between the charges using the ions. So that's how we achieve got to the higher energy density while keeping the power density same.
That's cool. Yeah. Now, supercapacitors are known for being able to supply a big burst of current real quick.
Correct.
But capacitors can't do that. Why the difference?
Because of the high energy density that contains on the supercapacitor while keeping the power density low enough, so it could discharge the high current really fast. While the regular capacitors may be able to provide the power, but very short of time, so it does not have enough energy density to provide enough power.
Interesting. Now we've got a couple of examples of supercaps right in front of us here. Why don't you tell us what we're looking at?
So these are the modules. So it comes with single cells, start with the single cells, and we package them into what customer needs. So one of these is more stationary applications, typically for the UPSs or indoor applications. And this is a ruggedized the module that could go into the vehicles or even, you know, the harsh environment.
About how much capacitor do we have in front of us here?
So, modules? So this one has a 62 volt, 130 farad capacitance. This product has a 48 volt and 166 farad.
What would you use these for?
So this thing is very useful for the short-term UPSs. So a lot of UPS requirements getting shorter as a minute to a second. So this one fits really well, replacing the batteries. And these one will be going something like the EVs or the hybrids to provide the short-term powers or the short-term energies that requires for the engine starting or capturing the energy from the braking.
I see. Kyle, if you incorporated this in a hybrid vehicle, could you reduce the size of the battery that you would normally use?
Yes, they can. It does two things. First of all, it can capture more energies from braking or accelerating, probably more powers. And so they don't need that big size of the battery. So they would play some of the battery with this and they can actually run more efficiently. And also it extends the battery life.
I see. Kyle, what kinds of supercaps does Eaton supply?
So Eaton has a variety of supercaps. So I can show you the smaller parts that we have. So it starts with the 0.1 farad all the way up to 3,000 farad on the single cells. And we also provide custom packaging requirements for the customer's need. And obviously we have these larger modules that goes up to 3,000 farad cells and combine them together.
Kyle, that's interesting technology. Thanks for telling us about it and tell us a little bit more about how supercapacitors work.
Well, thank you so much for the time.